The City of Biotechnology is celebrating its 15th anniversary. Despite its relatively short history, the technological park, specialized in agri-food, veterinary, and pharmaceutical sectors, has had a string of successes and built a reputation that extends far beyond the region. Located in Saint-Hyacinthe, in the heart of one of the most industrialized hubs in Canada, the City of Biotechnology has over 18 million square feet of space. It is bordered to the north by an applied research area housing the largest food processing research center in Canada, and to the south by the Quartier des Études Supérieures, a vast campus with several technology transfer and higher learning institutions, including the Université de Montréal's Faculty of Veterinary Medicine. The only French-language veterinary school in North America, the institution has built a world-class reputation, notably in animal husbandry and meat safety. The technological park is completed by an industrial area where over 30 high-tech companies have decided to set up shop. The main attraction is the support they receive from all these institutions in developing their products and production processes. Though they all work in the agri-food sector, these businesses specialize in varied areas, including food processing, biotechnology, and human and animal pharmaceuticals. Since its foundation, the city has also developed a considerable property portfolio. It now offers over 200 square feet of production and research space to young, innovative businesses. All these assets make Saint-Hyacinthe and its technological park a highly fertile ground for the agri-food industry. In 2018, nearly 3,000 professionals work in the City of Biotechnology every day, including 200 world-renowned researchers. It's a success story that is attracting international attention. In 2011, the European Commission named the city one of the best development models for its welcome and support infrastructures and for the synergy developed between its stakeholders. In that same year, the Association of University Research Parks picked the city as the world's best emerging research park from among a dozen international finalists. The technological park is the result of many years of political and economic action in Saint-Hyacinthe, which began over 40 years ago when the idea of creating an agri-food-focused technological hub first germinated. In the 1970s, Saint-Hyacinthe was hit hard by the textile crisis, which destroyed one of its industrial foundations. It decided to bank on agri-food to rebuild its economy. The strategy paid off, making Saint-Hyacinthe the first Canadian city to achieve the status of an international technopolis. In 1998, the idea of creating an agri-food-focused technological park in Saint-Hyacinthe was launched. The community quickly began laying the foundation for the project, which was already named the City of Biotechnology. A business plan was developed, and a great deal of effort went into setting up the first infrastructures to attract new businesses. In 2002, the results began to show. The City of Biotechnology was officially recognized by the Quebec government, which granted it significant tax incentives and set up a biotechnology development center to help young businesses in this sector. After 30 years spent developing an agri-food-based industry and 5 years of official steps to create a technological park dedicated to this sector, the City of Biotechnology was officially founded on January 16, 2003. That same year, Quebec's Ministry of Agriculture, Fisheries and Food transferred ownership of a 23-hectare property, which was the site of its former experimental farm, to the City of Saint-Hyacinthe so it could start its property development. The City of Biotechnology took possession of the two-year-old buildings and turned them into a biotechnology development center, today known as the Édouard Bourrachou Pavilion. In 2007, it inaugurated the new Victor Théodule d'Aubigny Pavilion, a 27,000-square-foot business incubator. In 2012, thanks to the access provided by the new José María Rosel Street, construction began on a new series of buildings, the Naturel XTD Pavilion in 2014, the Pharmaceutical Development Center in 2015, and the Rosel Pavilion in 2016. In 15 years, the City of Biotechnology has brought Saint-Hyacinthe considerable economic benefits in terms of investments and job creation. Since its foundation, it has attracted nearly $1 billion in public and private investments used to set up new businesses and modernize the major institutions. And the best is yet to come. With the support and engagement of the entire Mascoutin community, a number of large projects are already on the drawing table. The City of Biotechnology is one of the largest economic development projects in our region's history. For 15 years now, it has driven an innovative industry in Saint-Hyacinthe. It's a tremendous success we can all be proud of.